everybody. It's Michael with Asymmetrical Preparedness. Today I'd like to talk about knives. Very important to us as preppers, right? Yes, they are. All different kinds. You got fixed blades, you got folders, you got machete type knives, you got long knives, you got short knives, you got heavy duty knives, you got fillet knives. I mean, I'm not going to really talk about the fillet knives, the butcher knives, cooking knives, nothing like that. Prepper knives. Talking, you know, fixed blade, folders, and knives and multi-tools. Good knives. So it's good to have a variety. First off, they all have different purposes. They all have different things they're good at, things they're not as good at. For example, this is kind of like keying off the whole three knife challenge thing. That's why I have three. I just showed you three. Those are three I'm going to talk about, really. So having a good quality fixed blade knife is important. And yeah, this one is a, you can see right here, it's a Boker Magnum, decent quality knife. I mean, it's not a full-fledged Boker. It's their like value line or their cheapo line. But look at this. Look at the thickness of that thing. That's a thick knife. Nice and freaking solid. Of course, full tang. I got it wrapped with some of that camel form tape for better grip. And yeah, I've spray painted it before. I've sanded it. You know, I've worn it. I've used it. All the things. So good quality knife. This is a Boker Magnum. Kukum, I think is how you pronounce it. The style, the way the blade is, the way the blade is, and everything like that. It's really good. Is this nice flat edged back strap here for use of the ferro rod. It works really well. It's also really good. This is my primary fighting knife. This is in my plate carrier. Sorry, I got it mounted right here. So I just do a draw like that, draw and strike in one motion. So it's good to have, you know, knives that serve a lot of different purposes. I can baton with this, I can bushwhack with this, I can fight with this, I can, you know, I mean, I can cut up meat with this, I can do lots of different things with this. It's a good quality knife, you know, and this was like $80 to $100, so it's not that great. What I really want to get, I'm saving for an SE. SE knives are really good, ESEE knives, I really want to get one of theirs. But right now, this is what I got, so this is what I use. So, yeah. It's got a handle here. You can put a strap through, whatever you want to use it for. I don't really use that, but it's good for, you know, punching things, hitting things, hammering things. Yes, I've used it as a hammer. I know you're supposed to use a proper tool for the proper use, but, you know, hey, you can use it to punch out a window, bust a window. You can use it for lots of different things. So that is a fixed blade knife, good fixed blade knife. So I'll go into the folder next. And this has changed since I did my three knife challenge video because I had a CRKT knife. And this is my new ZT, Zero Tolerance knife. These are so sweet. I mean, it's all dirty now because I've been cutting, I've been harvesting a bunch of veggies. And so, yeah, I haven't cleaned it yet. Yeah, harvesting a bunch of zucchinis, cucumbers, a bunch of stuff like that with it today. So, yeah, it's a little dirty, but take care of your knives and they'll serve you well. This is ZT, so yeah, Zero Tolerance. It's a nice knife. It's good quality, great quality. I mean, it's nice and strong. It uses, what is it, S35VN steel. And, yeah, these things are all serialized because, I mean, this is a $300 knife. Now, I paid approximately half of that for it because $300 is a lot for a knife. But if you can get them a good deal, these are awesome knives. I highly recommend Zero Tolerance. They, you know, yeah, it does the things. You can see here, you know, beat up already using it. And yeah, I use it. I use it all the time. I use it for prying things. I use it for all the different purposes that you're not supposed to use a knife for. Yes, I get it. But yeah, having a good quality knife like this, and you can fight with this. You can do the things. You're not going to really baton with this. You could use this as a ferro rod because the back here is, it's beveled here. As you can see that little bevel here, but it still has a flat surface. So you could use it as a ferro rod if you needed to be, or if you needed to. But have a good quality folder, or a couple, or a whole bunch. Whatever. Good quality knives are very important. So what's another one? Another one is a very useful tool in general. This is a Leatherman Wave. You see right there. So this is the knife on a Leatherman Wave. It is very, 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 very sharp. I don't think I've ever even sharpened this one, and I use it all the time. I mean, I've had this knife for, 15 years at least. It's got the little slide lock right here to do that. So anyway, multi-tool, you know, it's got all the different things in it. But have a variety of different knives. that's kind of the point going here. You know, this has the serrated knife also in it, but I'm not really talking about that. I just think it's a good combination to have a good fixed blade right here, good quality fixed blade, good quality folder, and a multi-tool. These are the three that I would take with me if I needed to, say, grab three knives. It's just, like I said, it's good to have variety. You're going to do a bunch of different things with knives, serve a bunch of different purposes, and having, I'm not really a knife guy. I mean, I am a knife guy, but I'm more of a gun guy, of course, because I'd rather take a knife to a gun to a knife fight than a knife to a gun fight. So anyway, but having a good quality knife to fight with and, you know, hack to the bush with, this is one of my favorite knives. Having a big knife is, I think, is really important. And, you know, heavy duty, having the weight behind it is really important for when you are, you know, doing things like coming up behind somebody and, you know, doing the things. That weight helps drag through ligaments, tendons, body parts. I know, you don't really want to hear that, but it's really good for that purpose. So, have some good quality knives. This is just a, you know, video showing you a couple knives and trying to get you guys to get out and get some, you know, have some good quality knives. Don't just buy the cheapo Walmart $1 folders or anything like that. Spend, you know, $20. At least get like a Kershaw or a CRKT or, you know, there's a lot of other brands. Benchmade is out there. SE, you know, Buck. There's so many different knife manufacturers out there. I'm not throwing any out there specifically. If you got the money to get a really nice custom knife with a Kydex sheath, great. But that's one thing I recommend. That's a big thing. With a fixed blade knife that you want to get out quickly, like I have in my plate carrier here, I don't want to sit there and leather sheaths. I hate leather sheaths. Just personal preference. I know some people love them. But I don't want to sit here, unclip a retention device and then pull my knife out. If I want to pull my knife quickly, Kydex, just like my holster. For my gun. I don't have a leather holster because of sweat and other things like that. And I don't have a retention device, you know, that I got to unflip and stuff like that to draw my gun. Kydex. So I can just go, whoop, draw my gun, same with my knife. Quick draw, you know, whether you have it mounted here, whether you, wherever you have it mounted on your gear. Have it in a good quality Kydex holster. And you can use 550 cord through the little grommets onto your Molly webbing. That's how I attach my knives. So, yeah, get some good quality knives. Have some good quality knives. Get out and do the things. Use them. Use them. Don't just have them sitting in the safe like a like your rifle, Beauty Queen rifles. Get out and use your stuff. Prep a little every day, people, please. I love you guys, and I want you guys to be ready for trouble coming. Yeah, we all know what's on the horizon. You know, I worry about it, not worry about it because I'm prepared. But, hey, there's still that worry. So I love you guys. Stay positive. Blessings to you and yours.